Now we are going to see about 5th standard unit 1 forts and palaces. Forts na kote, palaces na that was built by the, you know, so Aranmanai palaces, okay. So in this lesson we are going to see the forts in Tamil Nadu and forts in Tamil Nadu. Apparently how the forts will be there, the palaces, about the palaces in Tamil Nadu, palaces in Tamil Nadu, and who built this and how they are maintained now itself, and explain the history of forts and palaces, about the history of forts and palaces. So these are the 3 points we are going to see in this lesson. Okay, so forts in Tamil Nadu, palace in Tamil Nadu, palaces, and about the history. History means on the forts every Katnanga, who built this fort, like this one by one we are going to see this now. Introduction. Tamil Nadu has been ruled by several empires, especially the Chera, Chola, Pandya and the Pallava rulers. So Tamil Nadu has several king empires ruled by them, mostly Chera, Chola, Pandya and Pallavas. You might have learned previous classes also. Cholas, Pandyas and Nayakas constructed magnificent fort and palaces in Tamil Nadu. So the fort and palaces magnificently, beautifully was constructed by the Cholas, Pandyas and Nayakas in Tamil Nadu. The Dutch, the British and the French in the moon pair entered our country and they built fort to protect their territories. They want to protect their territories. Territories na ellai inda taande inda ellaikulla avanga idu irukkan solittu. So the Dutch, the British and the French entered our country and they built the fort to protect their territory. So fort vandu kotai solluvanga, paathirpeenga in Velur also you have seen the fort kotai. So this is the fort. We will say this, the architectural monuments are now preserved in the form of palaces, fort and other historical sites in Tamil Nadu. Architectural monuments na kalainayamika monuments, ninaiva chinnangal, are preserved. Idala andha kala Cholas, Pandyas and Nayakas ivungalala build panna that palaces and forts, historical sites of Tamil Nadu. Adhudha nammalku historical sites avanga irundha kattinadhukku oru proof. Today only a few palaces and forts are in good condition. So only a few palaces fort in good condition la irukku. They are the prime attractions for tourists. Tourists na velinaatla irundhu varanga, they want to see the ovvoru oorliyum ovvoru monuments irukku, historical monuments. So almari they came from there, the tourists, they visit, the prime attractions for the tourists in Tamil Nadu. So first one is about the Velur fort. So first we will see about the fort. So fort is Velur fort. What is that? Velur fort. Velur fort. Kelvi pattirupinga Velur la irukra kotai. Velur fort is the 16th century fort situated in Velur. So it is the 16th century. This was built in the 16th century in Tamil Nadu and it was built by the King of Vijayanagara. Built by Kings of Vijayanagara. Okay. So 16th century leye inda court e vandu built pannitanga Vijayanagara, and it was built by the Kings of Vijayanagara. Among the fort in Tamil Nadu, Velur fort is considered the most invincible fort. So my irukra fort, among the fort kotali, Velur is considered one of the very important fort, and it is surrounded by a deep and wide moat. Agarin solvanga deep moat. The water of this moat, adhu kota inga irukana kotaikku munadi periya agari irukku, adhu full of surrounded with water, and it was a home of thousands of crocodiles. So neenga andha kotaikulla enter aagunona andha agari andha taandi dhaan ponu. If you want to get inside the water, the crocodiles anga irukku, thousands of crocodiles. It was feared by many raiders of the fort. So the kotai pudikinon varanga, what will they do? If they seen the crocodile, thousands of crocodile, they will fear. All are feared and then go off. The raiders of the fort. So this fort is a good example of military architecture. So military architecture or kalaina ethodu kattana, that's a good example. And it is studded with double fortifications. In 1779, Tipu Sultan's family was detained here by the British. The first rebellion against the British broke out at Belur in 1806. So 1799, Tipu Sultan's family was detained here by the British. Tipu Sultan's family was make it out. The first rebellion against the British broke out at Velur. Velur in 1806, they broke out. Okay, so first Sunday, 1806. Inside the Velur fort, there is a well-known temple. So, the Velur fort, temple is Jalakanteshwara temple, a church, a mosque, a museum, and several government offices. So, on the Velur fort, there is the church, as well as a mosque, and Jalakanteshwara temple, and a museum, and several government offices. Okay, this is about the Velur fort. So, it is the 16th century, built in the 16th century, built by the kings of Vijayanagara, and this is considered one of the most beautiful fort, invincible fort, and surrounded by deep and wide moat, and the water of this moat was home to the thousands of crocodiles, and it was feared by the many raiders of the fort. And this is a good example for the military architecture. So the military architecture karena itu ada anna mari kattirukanga, and it is studded with double fortification. Inga or kote inga kote, okay, double fortifications. In 1799, Tipu Sultan family was detained here by the British. So, torkadikapattargal. The first rebellion started by the British, broke out in Velur. The first started. So, first broke out. First rebellion was started in 1806. Okay. And this fort, inside this fort, there is a temple, mosque, and a church, and museum, and a government offices. And Velur has a five important mahals. What are the five important mahals? Five important mahals in Velur. What are the five important mahals? First one is Haidar Mahal. Then Haidar Mahal, Tipu Mahal, Begum Mahal, Candy Mahal. So these are the five important mahals. And Badshah Mahal, Badshah. Okay, so these are the five important mahals inside the Velur fort, as the five important mahals. Now, the next one is about the Dindukal Fort. Dindukal Fort. So this Dindukal fort is a 17th century hill, 17th century, 17th century hill fort situated in Dindukal in Tamil Nadu. It is also called as Dindukal Malai Kotai, also called as Dindukal Malai Kotai Sulvang. Malai Kotai, Dindukal Malai Kotai. Okay, this is also called as a Dindukal Malai Kotai. In the 18th century, the fort was passed on to the Kingdom of Mysore. So, 18th century, it was century. 18th century, the fort was passed to Yarkita Poche, passed on to the Mysore kingdom of Mysore. Kingdom of Mysore. So in the Dindigul Fort, kingdom of Mysore, kitta 18th century it went off. Okay. And Dindigul Fort was built by the Nayakars of Madurai. So Madurai and the Nayakars, they only built this Dindigul Fort in order to defend their region. Tangalude region e kaapathikkaradhukaga from invading the Mysore army. Mysore army kitta irundhu avanga kaapathikkaradhukaga they built this fort to defend the region. Avangalude ellaiye paadhukaathukku. Presently, the fort is maintained by the Archaeological Survey of India. So, ippa yaradhu maintain pannadhu the Archaeological Survey. So, in the mari forts, palaces, and the archaeological department only they will take us. So, the Archaeological Survey of India. The fort was cemented with double walls to withstand heavy artillery. So, the fort is with the double walls of cemented fort, cemented walls, because the heavy artillery works will be there. So, they built like this. Okay, see this Dindigul Fort. How nice it is, and the Malay lay the pani cut it on the fort. So this is about the Dindigul Fort. And Fort Jinjaj is the first fort built by the British India. So number Indians, Tamilians, they built a fort like this, Velur Fort and Dindigul Fort. Like this, the British has also built a fort. So Fort Jinjaj is the first fort built in India. And Fort St. George is located in Chennai. So St. George Fort, it is in Chennai only. The Secretariat, State Secretariat is functioning in the fort. So in the Fort St. George, this Fort St. George is Secretariat now function. Okay. And Thirumayam Fort, what is that? Thirumayam Fort is a famous for its artistic work and architectural brilliance. Thirumayam Fort, this one is artistic work, kalainayamika velaipaadugal solluvanga, and architectural brilliance. Indha kotaiyila katti irukkiradha architecture and the velaipaadugal works everything. And it is located in Pudukottai. So Thirumayam Fort enga irukkana Pudukottai. Thirumayam Fort is in Pudukottai. Okay. And Thirumayam Fort is popular for its large rock inscriptions. Large rock inscription of kalvettugalal porikkappatta kallai ezhuthi vechirupanga kalvettugalal porikkappatta. It's famous for its large rock inscriptions. It is also known as Umayan Kotai. So this Thirumayam Fort is also known as Umayan Kotai. Umayan Kotai. Okay. So the magnificent Sajjas Fort was built for commercial purposes by the Dutch. It is located in Kanchipuram. So Sajjas Fort. This Sajjas Fort. Sajjas Fort was built by Britishers for the commercial purposes. Built for commercial purposes. So this is in Kanchipuram. In Kanchipuram la irukku. So Dindigul Fort was Dindigul Fort is built in 17th century in a hill fort, Malaikotai solvanga, and this is also called as Dindigul Malaikotai. Hill fort na malayil kuda indirukapatta kote. Okay. And in 18th century the fort was passed on to the kingdom of Mysore, and this was built by the Nayakars of Madurai in order to defend edirigal kitta irundhu kaapathikkaradhukaga from the invading the Mysore army. Kitta irundhu thangala பாதுகாத்துக்கொள்வதற்காக இன்வேடிங். அண்ட் ப்ரெசன்ட்லி திஸ் வாஸ் மெயின்டைன் பை த ஆர்கியாலஜிக்கல் சர்வே ஆஃப் இந்தியா. அந்த ஃபோர்ட் வாஸ் சிமெண்டட் வித் டபுள் வால்ஸ் டு விட்ஸ்டாண்ட் த ஹெவி ஆர்டிலரி ஒர்க்ஸ். அண்ட் த மேக்னிஃபிஷன் சத்ராஸ் ஃபோர்ட் வாஸ் பில்ட் ஃபார் த கமர்ஷியல் பர்பஸஸ் பை த டச். ஸோ டச் ஒன்லி, டச் பீப்புள். ஓகே. அண்ட் தென் the Jinji Fort. Jinji Fort and the Senji Fort in Sulu India. So the Jinji Fort is another beautiful fort in Tamil Nadu. It is located in Vilupuram district. So Jinji Fort and the Tamil Nadu la irukku.
Jinji Fort. Jinji Fort is in Tamil Nadu. Okay, this is also in Tamil Nadu, and this is located in Vilupuram district. Inga irukku Vilupuram. Vilupuram district. And this fort is built across three hills. So three hills ku nadula this was built across the three hills. The fort walls are 13 km long and the three hills are connected by walls. So this was built by three hills, built across three hills. Okay, and these hills are connected by the 13 km long and connected by these walls. Connected by walls. And it is built at a height of 800 feet and protected by a 80 feet wide moat. So it evlo height naanga 800 feet. 800 feet height. 800 feet height and 80 feet moat. 800 feet height and 80 feet wide moat. Agarin sonna illaya wide moat, surrounded by water, wide moat. And it is a huge fort with many attractions like Kalyan Mahal, temples, Anekulam Pal, granaries and a watchtower. So in the fort la enna attractions na Kalyan Mahal, temples is there, and Anekulam Pond and granaries and a watchtower. And the next one is Tarangambadi Fort. So Tarangambadi Fort was is locally called Danish Fort. Tarangambadi Fort irukilla, that is known as the Danish Fort. Tarangambadi. Tarangambadi Fort is locally called as Danish Fort. Danish Fort, okay. And it is located on the shores of Bay of Bengal in Tarangambadi, Tranquil Bar of Tamil Nadu. So this is located in the Bay of Bengal in Tarangambadi. The fort is trapezoidal in shape and three rooms in the left wing. The central part of the fort has four rooms. The central pillar of the hall holds entire weight of the room. So the fort is trapezoid shape la irukum with three rooms in the left wing. Inga paranga trapezoid shape, three rooms in the left side, the three rooms irukum. The central part of the fort vandu four rooms irukum. See here, 1 2 3 four rooms will be the central part la. The central pillar of the hall holds the entire weight of the rooms, and the four rooms oda entire weight எது தாங்குதுன்னா the central pillar of the hall that holds the entire weight of the dome. Oh, this is about this children, Jinji Fort, Tarangambadi Fort, Velur Fort, Dindigul Fort. So far we have seen about the four forts. Okay, next we will see the in the next class children. Thank you.